Now in this lecture, we discuss on relationship between local and natural coordinates, shape function, and example of shape functions in finite element analysis. Now first we discuss on relationship between local and natural coordinates. Now consider figure 1. Figure 1 shows the two node one dimensional element. If we represent this two node one dimensional element in local coordinate system, then we says that node 1 is x1 distance away from origin, node 2 is x2 distance away from origin, and if we consider any point P on the element, then this P point is x distance away from the origin. This is our local coordinate system. Now if we represent this two node one dimensional element into the natural coordinate system, then we represent by node 1 is at eta is equal to minus 1 and node 2 is at eta is equal to plus 1. Now if we consider point P on this element, then this P point distance is given by considering point O, and we say that point O is eta distance away from the point P. This is our natural coordinate system. Now if we find out the relationship between this local coordinate system and natural coordinate system, then it is given by this equation, eta is equal to 2 x minus x1 divided by x2 minus x1 minus 1. Next we discuss on shape functions. Now properties such as displacement, strain, temperature, etc. within the element may or may not be linear. In finite element analysis, these variations need to be approximated within the element. In order to set or put these properties within the element, the shape functions are used. Now consider figure 1 of one dimensional element and having two nodes, node 1 and node 2. Now V represents displacement at node 1 by u1, and at node 2 displacement is u2. Means here displacement u1 and u2 is not equal, means not linear. So it is necessary to consider or correct this displacement, means to interpolate of these two displacements are necessary. Now these interpolations are given by considering two linear shape function n1 and n2. Now linear shape function n1 is given by 1 minus eta by 2, and linear shape function n2 is given by 1 plus eta by 2. Now if we discuss the characteristics of shape function, then it is given by first characteristics is generally shape function n1 and n2 are used in linear interpolation of displacement within the element, and second characteristics is sum of two shape functions n1 and n2 at any point within the element is equal to 1. Now next we discuss on property at any point within the element. Now to find out the property at any point within the element, we use the shape functions. Now if we consider to find out the displacement at any point, then we use this equation u is equal to n1 u1 plus n2 u2, where n1 is shape function and n2 is shape function. Now and u1 is displacement of node 1 and u2 is displacement at node 2. Similarly, if we want to find out the temperature at any point, then temperature at any point is find out by N1 T1 plus N2 T2, where N1 and N2 are shape functions and T1 is temperature at node 1 and T2 is temperature at node 2. Now let's take example. This example is method number 6 of FEA. Example is, one dimensional element has a length of 200 mm, temperature at node 1 and 2 are 100 degrees Celsius and 40 degrees Celsius respectively. Evaluate shape function associated with nodes 1 and 2 if temperature is to be estimated at point P within the element situated at 150 mm from node 1. Also calculate temperature at point P. Now we understand this figure in last theory. This one is local coordinate system and this one is natural coordinate system. Here length of element is given, means small l is equal to 200 mm. Then temperature at node 1, means T1 is given and T2 is given. T1 is equal to 100 degrees Celsius and T2 is equal to 40 degrees centigrade. Evaluate shape function, means we want to find out the N1 and N2. If temperature is to be estimated at point P, means point P is within the element. So point is P, is distance is given 150 mm from the node 1. So here X is given 150 mm. Also calculate temperature at point P, means temperature we want to find out. Now here x1 is equal to 0. Consider the figure 3. Here L is given 150 mm. Node 1 distance is not given from the origin. Directly node 2 distance is given. So we take x1 is equal to 0, x2 is equal to 200 and x is equal to 150 mm. Now shape function is find by the equation n1 is equal to 1 minus eta by 2 and n2 is equal to 1 plus eta by 2. Now if we want to find out the n1 and n2, then this is given by, first we want to find out the eta. So eta is find by this equation 2x minus x1, x2 minus x1 minus 1. So we simply put this value x1, x2 and x in this equation. So we get the answer 0.5. Now using this 0.5 we find out the n1 and n2. In simple, we put the 1 minus 0.5 by 2 and 1 plus 0.5 by 2. We get n1 is equal to 0.25 and n2 is equal to 0.75. Next we find out the temperature at any point P. In last theory we discussed that it is find out by this equation n1 t1 plus n2 t2. Here n1 is 0.25 and T1 is 100 degrees centigrade and T2 is 40 degrees centigrade. So we put plus 0.75 into 40. So finally we get 55 degrees centigrade. Thank you.